Good morning. The remaining topics of module 6 are DOS and DDoS, SQL injection, buffer overflow, wireless attacks. All are very important topics, similar to what we studied, like Trojan and backdoors, viruses and worms, steganography, and the initial topics what we study about password cracking. All are important topics, easy topics. If you just go through once and have my video and just remember the key points, you can easily write. Similarly, DOS and DDoS is a single topic. SQL injection is a single topic. So each these topics will deal in separate lecture. So today we will deal with DOS and DDoS, that is denial of service. So DOS, denial of service, means you are denying one service by attacking them. That is, you are denying somebody's service. What do you mean by service? Some resource. A person provides some resource. You are denying that resource. So as we have seen, you will see as per the book, a denial of service attack. And the next topic is DDoS, that is combined topic, a type of DOS, that is distributed denial of service, that is group attack. Then distributed means group of computers will be used for this attack. That's all. Denial of service means the same attack which is performed by one computer. Okay, what attack? What do you mean by DOS? Just group of computers used to perform DOS is called DDoS. So there is no that much problem about that DDoS. Then what is DOS? If you study and clarify all the points regarding DOS, then you can easily write what is DOS, and you can also have in your mind understand DOS for your future also. So one main point is to make the resource unavailable to the users. Just remember, suppose for example we studied a topic called backdoor, no, to bypass the security is called backdoor. So suppose Trojan means to disguise yourself under another program, like a wooden Trojan horse. For example, virus completely infect the other system once it is executed, and it attaches with other files. So for every term you should remember the keyword. Viruses means it will attach with the other files and replicate itself. So backdoor means overcome or bypass the security. Steganography. What do you mean by steganography? The art of hiding the information. You should thorough all topics keyword. You know, but you cannot express it until you are thorough with the keywords of each topic. So write and practice also. It is good, even though it is theory subject, just to write the topics of module 6. Because each topic, if you know what you are going to discuss, then you will easily manage. So write and practice. Similarly, DOS attack means to make a computer resource unavailable to the users. So if you are denying the service of a computer or resource of a computer, denying that resource to be unavailable for another person, another user. Denying means refusing. You are rejecting. You are denying. You are not giving. Then it is called denial of service. Okay. Now, in this type, the attacker floods the bandwidth of the victim's network and fills, for example, hundreds of unwanted email and fills your mail bandwidth. Bandwidth, you know what bandwidth means here. memory. So for example, you are given a 50 GB memory for a website. Okay, that explanation is given here. That attack name also is given. If somebody makes use of vulnerability in your computer, see here, bandwidth attacks. Loading any website takes some time. Loading means what? Complete web page appearing is called loading on the screen. And the system is awaiting for the user's input. So this loading consumes some amount of memory. Every site is given with a particular amount of bandwidth. For example, 50 GB. So 50 GB only given as a bandwidth for every website. Now if your website consumes all the 50 GB, then the hosting of the site can be banned. The attacker does the same. The attacker opens 100 pages of the same site and keeps on refreshing it and consuming all the bandwidth. Thus the site becomes out of service for the others. This is called bandwidth attack. I already shared the PPT, but I am depending upon the material because you are going to study with this material. So the same thing is given in your PPT also. Denial of service as types, classification, types based on levels, classification based on categories, DDoS. So denial of service, form of attack over a network, it is normally a malicious attempt to make the system unable to function. That is, the legitimate users cannot use the resources of a particular system which is under attack. It is a expensive crime. Attacker, internet, attacks a server by continuously sending unwanted requests or refreshing its pages and making too busy so that it cannot serve other users, legitimate users. Classification, volume based attacks or bandwidth attacks, that's what I meant now. It is one of the classification. Application layer attacks or programming flaws, failures of applications or OS components to handle exceptional conditions. It is unexpected data sent to a vulnerable component. So mainly the failures in the OS, operating system components, to handle the exceptional conditions is called application layer attack. Application layer means OS. The goal of this attack is to crash the web server. So other classifications are protocol attacks. Attacks will consume system resources. So protocols are the rules that you know. So the attack name is protocol attack. Some vulnerabilities will be there in the protocol. Okay. So example, TCP, transmission control protocol, sync flood, synchronization signal continuously sending and flooding. More means flood. Fragmented packet attacks, ping of death attack, smurf attack will be explained in the following slides. So protocol attacks means the protocols will have some bugs or vulnerability through which attacks can be made. Protocols, here are the rules that are to be followed to send data over network. These kind of attacks exploit a specific failure or vulnerability or implementation of bug of some protocol at the victim system to consume excess amount of its resources. Through that, it will consume all the resources. Through the bug or vulnerability in the protocol, it will consume all the resources. That is called protocol attack. Unintentional attacks means some friendly or unintentional DoS is happening when website experiences heavy traffic that users can no longer access. This is an unintentional attack. normally sometimes overloading occurs of a particular website. So it is not intentional attack. Protocol attack means vulnerability in the protocol is used to attack and consume its resources. Application means OS components have some vulnerability and handle exceptional conditions due to its failures in the OS. So that is called application layer attack. Volume based means bandwidth attack. 50 GB only given for a website. So if you are an attacker, you will open 100 pages of the website and make it denied for the other users. Make that website resource to be unavailable for other users. So what do you do is make a resources of a particular server or website or computer or a network unavailable for others, and these types are bandwidth, application layer, protocol, and unintentional DDoS. Levels of DDoS, in which level? So I told you, in protocol attack the examples are TCP sync, fragmented packet attack, ping of death, smurf attack. These are the examples. So at different levels these examples deal. So we'll categorize them as levels or types of DDoS attack: sync attack, smurf attack, ping of death attack, teardrop attack, land attack, nuke attack, permanent denial of service attack, UDP flood attack. So all these things, two to lines, you have to explain in which level the attack happens. Then you will just go for DDoS attack. Here the attacker gains illegal administrative access to as many computers on the internet. So many computers are used to perform this attack. That is called distributed denial of service attack. So the difference between DDoS and DDoS is many computers are used here in the diagram. Here one computer is used and multiple machines are used to launch this attack. Its difference is shown. More complicated DDoS. This is not that much complicated. There is no malware involvement in DDoS. Here some malware can be also used along with the DDoS attack. So the main definition of DDoS is cyber attack in which incoming traffic flooding is done from many different sources. Here the attack is done to make the resource unavailable to other people by only one computer. One computer is used to just absorb all the resources and attack particular server or website to be unavailable. So DDoS means denial of service, means unavailable. The service is unavailable, the resource is unavailable for others. Using one computer is called DDoS. Using many computers is called DDoS. How to protect? Buy more bandwidth, build redundancy into your infrastructure. So deploy anti DDoS hardware and software modules. Practice basic network security principles, understanding the warning signs whenever it comes. Maintain spare computers, establish a main and maintain regular backup schedules and policies. So build redundancy into your infrastructure means to make it as hard as possible for an attacker to successfully launch the DDoS attack or DDoS attack against you. How? Make sure you spread them across multiple area, so multiple data centers, with a good load balancing system to distribute traffic between them. So if your network, you have hundreds of computer, distributed them in different geographical position and give a load balancing. So there is a concept called load balancing of web servers, load balancing of LAN systems. So proper load balancing programs should be implemented. Then it is called building redundancy or load balancing capability to provide you fault tolerant network, that is infrastructure. More bandwidth, first itself you buy more bandwidth. So deploy anti-DDoS software and hardware protection. Even hardware also should be protected. So engaging in strong security practices called practice network security. Understand the warning signs. Whenever any symptoms of DDoS and DoS attack comes, you should not ignore the symptoms. Understand the warning signs. Some spares that can be replaced with this into service quickly should be maintained, spare parts. Establish and maintain regular backup schedules and policies. Always have a policy, backup and schedules. You have to maintain regularly. It's called how to protect DDoS and DoS attack. From how to protect your system from this DoS and DDoS attack. This 7 points you write, okay? Anyway, DDoS is simple, just many computers are used for providing the resource to be unavailable for users. So now in the material also we compare it and learn the classification, bandwidth attack, logic attacks using the vulnerabilities in network software, but only there it is maintained as application level. Here logic attacks, protocol attacks, protocol vulnerabilities are used for attack, unintentional attack, that is friendly attack. So just one name for application layer alone, here logic attacks is given. So for classification you write, then what is DoS, everything explained. So here buffer overflow technique is little bit explained here to commit such kind of criminal attack. So the IP address of a genuine user will be spoofed or forged with attacker's intention, and that will be used to send continuous request and make the victim to be confused and busy so that it will not serve the other legitimate users. The United States of Computer Emergency Response Team defines the symptoms are of DoS are symptoms: unusual slow, unavailability of particular website, inability to access any some website, dramatic increase in the email, spam email. These are the symptoms. The goal of DoS is to not gain unauthorized access. Like the previous topics, it is not going to gain the access of a system. It is to prevent. The main goal of DoS, it's a wrong goal, it is to prevent users of a service from using it. Okay, how flooding a network with traffic, disturb the connections, prevent a particular individual from accessing a service, disturb service to a specific system. Okay, so these points you can write for the introduction, classification, these points you can write, this four classification. So the levels, flood attacks, as I told, this is the level of some level of DoS attack. You use ping command to continuously overload the victim by sending request. Usually ping command which result into more traffic on the victim system that can handle. This requires the attacker to have faster network connection than the victim. It is very simple to launch, but to prevent is very difficult. Then ping of death attack means ICMP packets, you know, internet control message protocol. That packet for controlling messages will be sent between computers. So that controlling message is sent abnormally in different size, so that confusion will come to handle the oversized packet, and the server will, or the computer will crash that packet, and it will wait for so much time and it will become confused. This is called ping of death attack. Sync attack means, it is also termed as TCP sync flooding. Synchronization message is sent in TCP protocol. See, TCP protocol means, the TCP protocol is used for sending message. Protocol means set of rules for sending message. So TCP protocol using computers, that means the computer will use this kind of rules, TCP transmission control protocol rules, for exchanging the information. There is a sync, SIN, synchronization, and ACK, acknowledged messages will be transferred between them before sending the data. For example, here normal three-way handshake means, first time it will send a synchronization packet to the server, the client will send to server will send to client a synchronization acknowledgement, then only client reflects back with acknowledgement packet. So three-way handshake, in that it will, client will not send the acknowledgement. So only two processes over in this protocol, TCP using communication. And the third one, the client will not send. Client means, now the client is an attacker. So that the server will wait for too much of time, and time is consumed. This is called synchronization attack. Ping of death attack means, what I told, ICMP message is used during IP protocol is used. No? Here, third one, TCP protocol is used. Second one, IP protocol is used in some communication. At that time, this ICMP packet will be oversized and sent, and an attack is performed. So sync attack means, when TCP protocol is used between two computers for exchange of information, sync and ACK messages are used to maintain an attack. That means the third signal will not be sent from the client, and the server will be waited for, is made to wait for more time. So ping of death attack means, IP protocol, the message used is ICMP packets, oversized packets. Sync attack means, TCP protocol, the signal used is sync and ACK messages. Flood attack means, generally ping signal is used to send more requests. Similarly, 4, 5, 6. Teardrop attack. Teardrop attack is an attack where fragmented packets, so the, you know, fragmentation is happening in every internet communication. Okay, so the fragment size is changed, similar to that ICMP. And defragmentation, reassembly, there will be a confusion for the victim. So that kind of attack is called teardrop attack. Smurf attack is a way of generating significant computer network traffic on a victim network. So you are going to make very heavy traffic. This type of DDoS attack that floods the target system via spoofed broadcast ping messages by using ICMP echo request, not only ICMP signal ICMP packet, ICMP echo request is sent, and traffic is increased, and the resources are blocked or denied. This kind of attack is called smurf attack. Teardrop attack, fragment size of the packets are changed. The last one is nuke attack. Is an old DDoS attack against computer networks consisting of fragmented or otherwise ICMP packets which are invalid. Both things are used. So now, 6 level of attacks we studied, 4 types of classification of DDoS attack we studied. And DDoS means just a group of computers used. Some tools, names, Jolt2, NemeSync, Targa, Crazy, Pinger, Some Trouble. These are the tools name, no other way out by heart. And in boxes, some more points are given. Permanent attack, which damages the victim permanently by using the hardware vulnerabilities. Here, blended threat means different combination of threats, malicious codes, Trojan, everything will be used and denial of services performed. Okay, DDoS attack, as I told, group of computers used, that's all. How to protect that also we have seen in the slide. So we have used the slide and also the material for studying DOS and DDoS. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Bye.